And this will give me the change or decrease in energy when the system will expand by a volume dV. And now I do calculate this one, that this is the total energy, and take the derivative of this with respect to V. So what it will be? It will become minus 2 over 3 V, and minus 2 over 3 minus 1. And all this constant term will come in here, which is h bar square over 10 m pi square, and 3 pi square, 3 pi square n cube 5 by 3. So this is the constant term, and we are doing the derivative with respect to V, and it comes here. So I can simply write this one as I know E total. So if I write this V minus 2 by 3 and minus 1, so V power minus 2 by 3 and V power minus 1. So this minus 1 I can write like 1 over V here. V power minus 1, it will become V. Now look at this expression. If I look here, this is the whole, this constant term, then we are having V to the power minus 2 by 3. So this whole term is actually the total energy. And I can write that this dE is equal to minus 2 by 3, and the E total energy, the total energy divided by V. And okay, one thing that I have forgotten, this dV here, so the dV is here. This is dE by dV, this whole, and dV comes here. So I will write the E total and dV here. Now, as pressure is exerted, so when pressure is exerted, the total energy of the system will decrease. But I can see here that that system, when expands, it does some work. And how much that work will be, that work I can write that dW will be equals to P times dV. Now if you are not getting this relation, that how the work is pressure time volume, so let's look here, that as I know that work is force times distance, which I write S. If I divide this by distance square, means if I divide this by area square, then I will have to multiply this with area square. And this one, force per unit area, is called pressure. And this is distance or length into area. This is actually the volume. So I can write the work is pressure multiplied by the volume. And here, if I write differential work, then it will be differential volume, while the pressure is constant. So this one, further I can write that the pressure P will be equal. So from here, I can write that this is dW, this is actually this dE, because this is the work which is done and the energy in decrease by this much. So this is the work which the system has done. So dW by dV is the pressure. So pressure is dW over dV, which is dE over dV. So if I move this dV here, then I can write that this is, now it's pressure, so the pressure is exerted by the system. I can write this as a positive gradient. So this is equal to 2 over 3 and E total, 2 over 3 E total divided by V. When this dV comes here, 2 over 3 E total. So I can write the pressure is equal to 3 pi squared 2 over 3 by putting the value of E total over 5 m and h bar squared rho 5 by 3. And this pressure we call in quantum mechanics is the degeneracy pressure. This is the degeneracy pressure. So what we did, we calculated the total energy of the system, and further, is this total energy of the system will behaves like the internal energy, or it is the internal energy of the system. So this will do some work, this will exert some pressure on the barrier or on the walls, and we calculated that pressure will decrease some of the total energy. And how much it will decrease, we found it that it will decrease this much energy, and that pressure we calculated, which is exerted by the system on the boundaries or on the Fermi surface, and this is that pressure which in quantum mechanics we call is the degeneracy pressure. So this was all about the free electron gas model, and when we will solve an example on this one, many other points will get clear to us as well. Thank you. Now we solve problem 5.13 in your book, and the problem is that the density of copper is 8.96 gram per cm cube, and its atomic weight is atomic weight is 63.5 gram per mole. So we are asked to calculate the very first, the Fermi energy of copper. The Fermi energy of copper. And we will have to assume that each copper atom is given one free electron, and we will have to calculate the Fermi energy in electron volts. So now we know that to calculate the Fermi energy, we know that the Fermi energy is equal, as we calculated, that this is h bar square over 2 m e mass of electron, a 3 pi square rho and to the power 2 over 3. So here, if I do here, h I know that this is 6.625 10 raised to the power minus 34, and h bar is over 2 pi. Mass of electron, I know this is 9.11 10 power minus 31 kg. And rest phi is there. So the only value that I will have to calculate here is rho. And rho, how to calculate rho from the given data? And this we will do. And I know that rho is equal as we did nq over v. Now q is equal to 1, so this is n over v. And I will now calculate the n over v, number of atoms per unit volume, and this can be calculated. If I know the number of atoms per mole, and then I multiply it with moles per gram, and then multiply with gram per volume, or from volume here I mean the density, means we can write the density here in gram per cm cube. So mole cancel with mole, gram cancel with gram, and we are having atoms per volume. So now do calculate this one. Atoms per mole, we know that what is atoms per mole, and if I write in 1 mole we are having Avogadro numbers of atoms, so I can write this one, the gram per mole being the atomic weight, so this will be 1 over atomic weight, and atoms per mole will be the Avogadro number. So this is Avogadro number which we call the Na, and which is equal to 6.02 10 power 23 Na, and mole means atoms per mole is this one multiplied with atoms mole per gram. So gram per mole is the atomic weight, and which is given to us is 63.5. So I can write this over 1 over m, the atomic weight, 1 over m, the reciprocal of this, and then multiply it with gram per volume. So it is mass per unit volume. I know density is mass per unit volume, so it means this thing is the density in gram per cm cube. So it is here, so this is the density, and this will give me the required rho here, that what is it, and put the values. Now Na, I know that Na is equal to 6.022 10 power 23, and it is atoms per mole. So put the value of Na, put the value of 63.5 here, gram per mole, and put the value of D here, which is 8.96, and we will calculate rho here, and then put the value of that rho here, and we will have the Fermi velocity, the Fermi energy, is equal, the Fermi energy will come out to be equal to 7.0 electron volt. We know the conversion of the electron volt as well, that one electron volt is equal to, if I write this in the form of joules, then 1.602 × 10⁻¹⁹ joule means the electronic charge into joule. So this will give us the Fermi energy. And now question 2 is that what is the corresponding electron velocity? That corresponding electron velocity, is it safe to assume that the electrons of copper are non-relativistic? Are non-relativistic. Means when we will calculate the velocity of the electrons in copper, then we will decide whether they are relativistic or they are non-relativistic. Now we know that energy, Fermi energy we have calculated is equal to half mev squared. So this will be Vf. And now from here I can calculate the V is equal 2E over M, 2E over M and square root. So this M is the mass of electron which is here. EF we calculated as this one. Now is mass, we will either we write mass in the form of electron volts, R means in the form of MeV, and or we write this EF in terms of joule, then it will be right, and the velocity will come out to be 1.6 × 10⁻⁶ meter per second. This comes out to be the velocity of electrons. Now in order to check that whether it is relativistic or non-relativistic, then do compare it with the speed of light. Find V over C. Now V is 1.6 × 10⁶ and C is 2.99 × 10⁸, and this approximately is 0.0053, and we can easily say that the electrons in copper are non-relativistic because this is much much less than the speed of light. Third question is that at what temperature would the characteristic thermal energy, which is the kBT, the thermal energy which we call ET, and this is kB, the Boltzmann constant multiplied with temperature, is equal to the Fermi energy. What will be the temperature? Now the kB value, I know the Boltzmann constant, this is 1.38 × 10⁻²³ joule per Kelvin. So I can easily calculate the temperature at which these two energies will be equal, and this is EF is equal to kB and TF. This is the Fermi temperature. So this implies by putting the values, calculate this one in joule, and now we will have this temperature equal to the implies the TF is equal to 8.110 raised to the power of 4 Kelvin. So this is almost 81,000 Kelvin temperature. 81,000. So 81,000 Kelvin. And if I look at the melting point of copper, then this is equal to 1356 Kelvin, which is much less than the Fermi temperature. And when this value is much less than the Fermi temperature, then we can call the copper is cold. When the Fermi temperature is much higher than the melting point of that material, of that metal, we term is the cold material. And D, calculate the degeneracy pressure. The degeneracy pressure of copper in the electron gas model. Now, is the degeneracy pressure is equal to 3 pi square 2 over 3 h bar square rho 5 over 3 divided by 5 m e. So now it's just a numerical to put the values. We know the value of rho here, we calculated. We know the value of h bar, pi, me and all this, and the pressure will come out to be 3.8 10 raised to the power 10 newton per meter square. So this way we just from a little data of density and the atomic weight of copper, we calculated many parameters. So as assignment, you can do as assignment, you can do problem, which is the next problem, 5.14. And this will give you more insight into the free electron gas model. Thank you.